Everyone knows about the Bitcoin halving, which is a highly anticipated event that happens every 4 years. But did you know about the Ethereum triple halving? The Ethereum triple halving is a term used to describe three factors that are providing deflationary pressure to the Ether supply. In this video, we'll explain the Ethereum triple halving and how it can affect the prospects of Ether as a long-term investment. It's important to keep in mind that unlike the Bitcoin halving, the Ethereum triple halving is not an actual event built into the Ethereum protocol. Instead, it's a term that the Ethereum community came up with to describe how new mechanisms implemented in the Ethereum protocol are helping reduce the supply of Ether. The concept of the Ethereum triple halving consists of three main parts. Reduced Ether issuance under proof of stake consensus. Ether burning via the EIP 1559 upgrade. Staking lowering the amount of Ether that is effectively in circulation. Ethereum's migration from proof of work to proof of stake has had a very significant impact on the Ether supply. The reason for this is quite simple. The Ethereum blockchain has to issue much fewer Ether to reward stakers than the amount of Ether it had to issue to reward miners. More specifically, the Ethereum protocol was issuing around 13,000 Ether per day to reward miners under the proof of work model. Under the new proof-of-stake model, the Ethereum protocol only has to issue about 1,600 Ether per day to reward stakers. This is a reduction of about 87.7%. According to Ether supply tracker Ultrasound Money, the Ethereum supply has decreased by about 282,000 Ether in the last 271 days. According to the aggregator's estimates, the supply would have instead increased by 2.8 million Ether in the same time period if Ethereum still used proof of work. As we can see, Ether has been slightly deflationary since the transition over to the proof-of-stake consensus mechanism. If this trend continues, it favors long-term Ether holders since Ether will become increasingly scarce, providing positive pressure to the coin's price. The second part of the Ethereum triple halving is the EIP 1559 upgrade, which was activated through the London hard fork in August 2021. The upgrade reworked Ethereum's transaction fee structure with a mechanism in which the base Ether gas fee paid for transactions is burned. EIP 1559 is the reason why the Ether supply has decreased despite new Ether coins being created every day to reward validators. When demand for transactions on Ethereum grows, more Ether is burned. So far, the amount of Ether burned through EIP 1559 has outpaced the amount of Ether that's being issued, resulting in a slight reduction in the Ether supply. If demand for transactions for Ethereum drops in the future, however, we could see Ether becoming inflationary again. Ether staking is the third factor included in the Ethereum triple halving concept. Following the move to proof of stake, Ether holders can stake their coins to help secure the Ethereum network and earn staking rewards in exchange. This part of the Ethereum triple halving has become a bit less relevant recently. This is because the Shapehala upgrade, which was enabled in April 2023, introduced the ability to withdraw staked Ether coins. The ability to withdraw Ether hasn't actually translated to a flood of Ether withdrawals. It appears that most Ether stakers are happy to continue staking their coins and passively earn yield on their holdings. In fact, we can see a sharp uptick in the amount of staked Ether after the Shanghai upgrade went live on April 12, 2023. This means that overall, the upgrade increased confidence in Ethereum's staking system and made a larger number of investors willing to stake their coins. At the time of recording, there's a total of 22.7 million staked Ether. Now that Ether holders have the option of withdrawing their staked coins, staked Ether can no longer be counted as removed from circulation. Still, the ability to stake Ether is an incentive against selling, so one could still argue that Ether staking is still a positive influence on Ether as a long-term investment. Do you think Ethereum is a good hold for the long term, or do you prefer other cryptocurrencies? Make sure to let us know in the comments below.